Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, this is your welcome to V-Dite Nitro. This is yours truly, the GM Factor, Joseph Matos. And man, look, as Femme Fatale keeps getting closer and closer, things are thickening, tensions are rising. Mickie J is still on her quest to get a championship shot. She thought that, well, Fred wouldn't give her one, and Mio's like, nope as well. And now this is considered for her a Kickstarter. And I'm not talking about the Kickstarter in which you donate money to. So right away, the jumpstart that would be facing Chun-Li. And believe it or not, even without me even mentioning key things, people have pulled out their arcade sticks. Oh my god. I guarantee you, if we see the rabid kicks, they will be tapping the kick button. I guarantee you. I wonder if we'll actually see that. Yeah. Alright, so here we go. Santa Bell and the match is underway. Who was two steps from rock bottom, now back in rock bottom. Let's see if she can actually get that start to her road to a title shot by getting past Chun-Li. Then you also got to take it on the fact that Yuna and Riku will be facing both Rinoa and Tina Armstrong tonight. But the way Mio acts, the way shady and power abusing, and then people would compare it to how I was, and still to this day, She makes me feel like an angel. Can you believe that? The way that she acts on it, she makes you wish that I was a freaking saint. And only those who know me pretty well back in the olden days will get what I'm talking about. It's Mickie James laying the hammer on Chun-Li. Chun-Li shoving Mickie, getting some space. Going right into a bulldog. Just running cross body. If there's anything Mickie James better be careful about are Chun-Li's kicks. So getting a little bit overconfident. That was a very stupid move. And Mickie James making her pay for it with a series of lariats. Getting some knee to the spine. And more kicks to the spine ain't gonna help. Leg hooked. One. Only one. Also, Yana Wonder, with the fact that Mio's been trying to take the Senshi out piece by piece, I feel that Usagi has like the mentality of don't trust anybody, because you have no idea if anybody you know in the roster is on your side at all. Others could be trying to gun for you as well to finish what the Dawns of Darkness started. And I wouldn't blame Usagi for feeling that way. Me hell. If you had the entire world against you, what would you do? Chun-Li handspring back elbow. Oh, missing the handspring back elbow. Mickie James once again catching her with the lariat. It was a bait and switch. I got her in a front face lock. Chun-Li transitioning right into a go behind. Sets up for ride. Wait, got her. There, leg hook. One, two. Wait, Mickie James shifted her weight. One, two. No, only two. That was close to a three. You taste. For an elbow now, Chun-Li with the knee to the stomach. Right now throwing Mickie James into the corner. As Chun-Li got up on her upper sleeve. He's giving her sending her into the corner again. I think she's gonna try to go for the handspring back elbow. No, Mickie James avoiding it. Now she throws Chun-Li into the corner. She connects with that clothesline. Mickie James just baiting Chun-Li into certain attacks. And so far that's game plan is actually working. There was a kick to the midsection. Sunset flip, but did not connect, did not hook the waist for a cover, and now going up top. Chun-Li in a daze. Mickie James says press off the top rope. Now you see someone trying to actually do a Thes press off the top rope. And a try to go for a corkscrew senton, and well, put it simply, nope. Chun-Li with the quick recovery. You know, you see the damage from this match affecting her. Here we go, figure four neck lock. Figure four neck lock, trying to choke out Mickie James. Chun-Li getting back in the ring. Oh, it could be kick time. It could be kick time. The people are getting their arcade sticks ready. They're ready to tap the kick button. Nope. Mickie James with the evasion. Mickie James like, tap this. 360 motion, plus three punches. She countered the regular special move with an ultra combo finish. Well, this victory did do one thing. Well, it didn't strengthen the soul of Mickie James. It kickstarted her up. There she countered the special move with the ultra combo finish, the Mickie DDT. Talk about a big turnaround. This will definitely be a start in Mickie James' journey of trying to get a championship shot. And what title, I have no idea. Well, this will be a good Kickstarter. And once again, I'll say it again, not the one where you donate. Well, there's Rinoa and Tina. Oh wait, there's Tag Team Champions. Meanwhile, in the parking lot, Jessica Simpson, who forgot to put her face paint on again, using the power of the Juggalos to try to take the Hardcore Championship from Dixie. Dixie was probably just getting in the building or was probably taking a walk, and Jessica Simpson just came out of nowhere, jumped her from behind in an attempt to try to get the Hardcore Championship. Remember guys, the Hardcore Championship is 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You could be in the bathroom or in the shower. You can get jumped by somebody for the Hardcore title. Jessica Simpson, hungry for Hardcore Championship gold. And Dixie throwing her into the car. I have a feeling that's probably Danica Patrick's car. Man, nobody likes Danica Patrick. property damage everywhere. There's a big clothesline. That ain't ring. That is concrete floor. Now destroying Dixie once again across the parking lot. Now throwing her into that sedan. I got a feeling that's Ashley's sedan. Oh, punching her right into the sedan. But if I was Ashley's engine, I hope I have insurance or Geico auto insurance right now. Or that's where Allstate stands. Are you in good hands? People need a lot of car insurance when they bring their cars into this parking lot. Dixie right now is just mauling Jessica Simpson. Hell, if I was Dixie, if I had her laid out, I could just walk away right now. Dixie could probably walk out of here with the hardcore title. If she survives this assault. Ooh, right into that other car. I have no idea who drives that one. Ooh, trunk right into the back. I don't know what Jessica Simpson was going to try to go for. Whatever it was, it could have been pretty big on that concrete floor. I think Dixie was going to try to go for that powerbomb for the Psycho Driver. Uh-oh. It was a backbreaker. Oh, this is going to... Oh, my God! Right on the concrete floor. I had... And, well, Jessica Simpson is the new hardcore champion. But I was sorry, I would get the hell out of this building. So we leave with a new hardcore champion. Dixie laid out unconscious on the concrete floor. Looks like this is going to be one of the singles matches that Neo had in mind. Miku will be facing Tina Armstrong in this one. Gullwings were given instant tag team title shots against Haruka and Michiru. It ain't looking good. There was no contenders. I think they were just handed it on a silver platter. And then Ritu friggin' bashed Michiru in the back of the skull with a steel pipe. That ain't normal hunger for attacking titles. We're talking about bloodthirsty. Bloodthirsty that they're so bloodthirsty that they'll do anything necessary to weaken them as much as possible to make it easier for them to fend to death. I guarantee you. But in a way, this could be good for both Rinoa and Tina as well. Primarily more for Rinoa. Because Rinoa could possibly finally get her revenge on Yuna. But putting through all this crap, it also driving Riku to actually, you know, join back with Yuna. And if Tina could get a victory here in this battle with Riku, it would definitely be a momentum boost for Rinoa later on tonight. Tina has to be very careful. She's had encounters with Riku before, and that last in the last CPV. She knows that Riku can actually be pretty crafty if she wants to be. But this ain't gonna be like how it was in that tag match. This is one on one. Riku already proved to be a little bit overconfident, and Tina made her pay for the consequences. Riku with the back elbow. Tina shoving her. Trying to build space. Here you go, collar will tie up. Who will have the better grip here? No, they both are even. Tina missing that spinning kick. Riku delivers some strikes, followed by a slap that disoriented Tina. Got over the shoulder. No, Tina countering with a reverse DDT. Now, sets her for a ride. Riku counting with a neck breaker. Tina has to be careful because Riku. Is pretty quick. He's got a lot of agility. Remember, this was a former NGW Women's Champion. Keeping right in the stomach move, followed by a lariat. Very stiff drop kick. punched ahead. Once again, just pin, is having Tina pinned down to the Tiny corner, trying to choke her out with her knee. Now throwing Tina in the other corner, trying to overdrop, you know, Tina, with that veteran experience, is able to sidestep out of it. Now she's got her over the shoulder. Spinning her right into a sidewalk slam. The power of Tina Armstrong. Now Tina delivering kicks. She has slapped a bad kick. Got over the shoulder again. Into the cutter. Into the over the shoulder cutter. And a drop kick. Did you see the quickness behind that drop kick? And now Tina pulling her right into a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Tina overwhelming Riku with a lot of power moves. And technique. Here's some more technique for you. Tina giving Riku more than she bargained for. Got her in the corner. Wait, throwing her Irish whip. Ducking under. Running through. Oh man, she clotheslined her literally inside out. One, two, no. That was definitely close to a three. Things are going well for Riku right now. Shoulder tackle, right shoulder tackle, right to the outside. That was Tina. I would stay in that ring. Recover. Oh wait, never mind. Big springboard senton to the outside. Oh, Riku with the atomic drop. Riku is trying to turn this around. Tina built up a lot of momentum. Oh, this could be a game, and that could be a game changer. As well as that, will make things a lot worse. Doing as much damage to the back of the leg, to the legs as much as possible. Oh, that post ain't gonna help matters. One skull needs steel post. The steel post will always win. And that definitely could possibly turn things in Miku's favor. It's capitalizing on the opening that she made. The neckbreaker followed by another one. One, two, no. Tina could be still disoriented. But wait, Tina, with the quick recovery. Riku, a dazed mess. Trying to go for the diamond cutter, no. Tina tried to go for the diamond cutter. They got countered right into a spinning heel kick. Riku with a kick to the midsection, throwing Tina. I think she'd be going for the sunset flip, but did not hook the waist again. Going for a cover. One, two, no, only two kick. For Tina, things aren't really doing, or things going well for her. Leg hook, one, two, no. Clothesline. Tina in a lot of trouble. Riku is taking control of this matchup. Now Riku going up top. As Riku got a minor. Just literally driving that head right into the chest. Trying to overdrop Tina. Able to slide throw her right back down. Now Tina going up top. But Riku just literally dropping here. Tina in trouble. Wait, no. Tina countering with a kick to this kick. Riku dazed. Big, vicious overcastle. One, two, no. I really thought that was going to be enough. See, pulling her right into a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Tina was it going up. Connecting with that senton splash off the top rope. Pulling her away from the ropes. It's that veteran experience. Tina going up. The arm breaking moonsault of doom. Nope, that did not connect at all. Tina so far keeping the pace. Get her over the shoulder. You're gonna see that. She had a minor. It's gonna be time for a Death Valley driver. Connecting with the Death Valley driver. Now what has Tina got in mind? Tina now going up top. The arm breaking moonsault of doom, the leg hook. One, two, no. I really thought that was going to be enough. Oh, wait a minute. The roll up. One, two, no. Only two count. But once again, trying to control the match with that neck breaker. In one, two, no. Gano, another near fall. Trying for a spinning heel kick, only grazed Tina. Tina's running with a spinning back kick, that got evaded. Back into the tie-up, no. Tina going right, counting it right with a front headlock, and going right with that knee. Riku once again trying to daze, once again going, connecting with that move again. Now Riku going right back up top, and delivering the elbow. And another elbow, that's two elbows. One, two, no. Tina was able to kick out of two elbows, could not avoid the bulldog, the face crusher now. Oh. Could be time for the elbow drop. Wait a minute, it's Michiru. Michiru came out of nowhere. Oh. Riku getting all up in Michiru's face. She just bitch slapped Michiru. And wait a minute. Diamond cutter. She turned right into the diamond cutter. Michiru is still out. One, two. Michiru took one for Tina. And that led to Tina taking advantage of Riku being distracted. Getting it right in the diamond cutter. Big slap of death. And Tina saw that opening. Diamond cutter. Michiru sacrificing her face for Tina to beat Riku. And thanks to Michiru riding that backup at the time it was needed, Tina was able to get one up over Riku. Now the real question is, can Rinoa get one up over Yuna? Will she get her revenge on Yuna? That is the million-dollar question. But we're not going to know until we find out later tonight. But for now, this could be a big momentum boost coming to later on tonight. Oh, wait a minute. Urza confronting the greatest. Jeez, why can't anyone just leave Lightning alone? Oh, you've got to be shitting me. Are you kidding me? Oh, Lightning, I think I see smoke coming out of her ears. The greatest of all time is pissed. It's bad enough that you made that Arizona Lightning tap out for the very first time in her career. Yeah, what is the real reason? Oh god, I think Lightning doesn't give a damn about the real reason. Wait, Finn Fitzal? Lightning, what do you got in mind here? Tables match? A tables match? Lightning wants a piece of Urza at Femme Fatale in a tables match. Oh god. Urza, I'd watch what you say if I were you. It's bad enough the greatest of all time is in a very foul mood now that you just showed up. It's on. Urza accepts the challenge. How can you make someone tap in a tables match? And oh god, here we go. They're going at it right now. The greatest and Urza are battling it out in the parking lot. We're going to see an all-out brawl. And ah, FCW security with their developmental powers are holding back Urza and the greatest. Oh come on, let him go. I got to see them go. Ah, damn it. And what a development. Femme Fatale, Lightning, she will be fixing Urza in a tables match. But how the hell is Urza going to make Lightning tap out in a tables match? We all know the only way to win a tables match is when you're going through the table. And for those of you who don't remember, Laura Croft was the hardcore champion. She got jumped by Zhao Yu 2 weeks ago. In which we saw the most historic, the most hilarious thing in the history of wrestling and CAW. The day when we saw Laura Croft, WWE legend, job to a water jug. We will never get over it. It will be highlighted. It will be in the record books. Laura Croft job to a water jug. Thanks to this woman, Lin Xiaoyu. Lin Xiaoyu won the hardcore title 2 weeks ago, but ended up losing it as soon as she had it. And Laura Croft looking to get payback in Xiaoyu for what happened 2 weeks ago. I mean, hell, if somebody lost to a water jug, I'd be pretty pissed off too. Laura Croft, this is payback. Xiaoyu, I don't think there's going to be a water jug to use on Laura Croft here in the ring. Here we go. Xiaoyu taking on Laura Croft, former CCL Women's Champion, and one of the legends of our industry. Here we go, collar elbow. So he's gonna get the advantage here. Laura Croft gets the advantage. Xiaoyu transitioning right into a side headlock. No, a counter transition to an arm wrench. We're gonna block each other's blows here. Xiaoyu using some kicks. Or was able to sidestep it, going for some punches and kicks of her own, followed by a front dropkick, but it only grazed Xiaoyu, it didn't bring her down. Just working on that arm, and just giving, dropping all that weight, just dropping that leg right on the arm. If there's any limb you really don't want to break, and that is the arm. Because then if your arm is broken, and trust me guys, my arm was broken before, you'd be practically helpless if it's your dominant arm. Gotta pin the apron. And Xiaoyu, once again, working on that arm. Just dropping this body splash, another body splash. You know, a cover, one, no, only one. I mean, Xiaoyu will be able to hold Laura Croft, but you know, the weight difference is right there. Big elbow. Discus elbow. There you go, Irish whip in the corner. Laura Croft, handspring back elbow. I feel like things never go in the way of Xiaoyu. I mean, hell, when was the last, when you think about it, did Xiaoyu even win? I don't even think Xiaoyu has won a match. Except that hardcore title match, technically that would be her very first win since being in VWF. Put right into a backbreaker. But a victory over Laura Croft, well, that would be pretty big. Beat a CW legend. Oh, wait a minute. Roll up. Got her to roll up. One, two, no. Xiaoyu trying not to panic, trying not to get frustrated. Caught her right with the Dez press. Staying on her, which is pretty damn smart. Kick to the spine. Now going up top. She's going up top. What is Xiaoyu got in mind here? You are a dazed mess. Trying to let it know. She missed. Laura Croft was like, nope. And a dropkick to the side of the head for your troubles. Neck break. And now grabbing that leg. Just dropping all that weight on it. The party don't want broken the knee. And that this won't help matter. Shin breaker. And again, dropping all that weight on the leg. Just trying to slow Xiaoyu down, trying to slow her mobility. So that way she won't be as mobile, and her kicks won't be doing as much damage. Smart tactic here by Laura Croft. Leg hook, one, two, no, only two. I'm trying to pull her back, Xiaoyu countering. But the leg that was not worked on, and an elbow right to the head. Stomping to the shoulder. Getting some distance, neck break. Trying to catch with the springboard body splash weight. Going for it again, off the second rope that time. Oh man, there's such a thing called repeat offender. You jump, you take the well too many times, my friend, and then it will work. X Factor. Lord Croc with the X Factor. And I think Lord Croc could be any of them. It could be Tomb Raider time. And here it is. She's got her up. Tomb Raider. No. Zhao Yu with a knee to the head. Gonna throw a back kick. No. Fire over front drop kick. No. Zhao Yu was able to counter that. I don't know what Zhao was going for. Whatever it was, got reversed. Lord throwing her into the outside, hit tossing her right back in the ring. She's like here to deposit Zhao Yu to the ring bank account. They got her eight, no. Counter transition. Shot into the back. So you better be careful, I get too overconfident here. You're making a lot of mistakes. And Laura going up top. Laura's going up top. Zhao Yu trying to get back up to her feet. Catch her with a beautiful crossbody. Now what is she up to? Down and out. I think she's waiting for the move for Zhao Yu to get back up to a vertical base. And famous or off the top rope. Good lord. Man, if I was Laura, I would have went for the cover right there. That could have been it right there. Truck came right to the side of the head. I felt that could have been over off the famous one at the top rope. And oh man, that was too bad to be a 2.9. And wait a minute, Zhao Yu with the roll up. One, two, no. Rolling, shifting her weight. Two, three. Lord Croc beat Zhao Yu a roll. What a counter roll up. Man, if that doesn't feel Zhao Yu's ire of the fact that she's only got one win, I don't know what win. Zhao Yu could right now be constantly being boiled with rage. Rage was over the rage. Just throw that jockey to the side of the head. That was when Zhao Yu kicked out. This was where it ended. After she shifted her weight with a counter rolling, it was game over right there. This victory strengthens the soul of Laura Croft. Laura Croft gets her revenge on Zhao Yu for trying to bury her with a water jug. She came back with great vengeance. And wait a minute! Hinata! What the? Oh my god! Hinata friggin' dropped Jessica Simpson into the friggin'. Into that thing! With all the computer equipment! Hinata is beating the living crap out of Jessica Simpson. She wants the hardcore title. Remember, the only title Hinata has ever won was the tag team titles with Sakura. Oh my god! With Sakura until Sakura sold out. Still to this day, we still don't know why she betrayed Hinata like that. And Hinata trying to go for her very first singles championship. But I didn't think Hinata would be interested in going after the hardcore title. In my opinion. Listen, Hinata proving, even though she's extremely shy and pretty nervous of being around others, she could be hardcore when she wants to be. And we're seeing that side right now. This side of Hinata we've never seen. Seeing history right here. Hinata throwing Jessica Simpson right into that duel. Here, let me open that for you. Hinata is literally beating the crap out of Jessica Simpson. Still gonna get the crowd is on their feet. The crowd is on their feet for Hinata. They want Hinata to make history. They want Hinata to win her very first singles title. Hinata literally doing a number on Jessica Simpson in the back. Can you believe it? Uh-oh. No. Hell, Jessica Simpson has barely even did any type of move on Hinata. Hinata can get this with a flawless victory. Oh, wait, there it is. The eight trigrams. The eight trigrams. Knee. We have a new hardcore champion. Hinata just made history. She won her first singles title. Meanwhile, back in the Senshi locker room. Until Miyazaki pulled out the VWF app. Yes! Yes! Oh great, no! 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 Why? The Gears of War are at it again, back in the bottom of the barrel. Doesn't seem to be getting out of the bottom of the barrel anytime soon. If I had a garbage can, right, and I put the Gears of War in it, they'd be deep in the crevice of the garbage juice. They're the garbage juice of the garbage can. Smelly, smelly garbage. With no hope of escaping it, and their only hope would be going down the garbage chute. When they hear the people are gonna throw them down the chute. The sirens. Boys, not even Harley Quinn will be doing pretty well on the tag team circuit. Still trying to advance in their quest for the tag team titles. But out of whack Harley is on a daily basis, how the hell does Poison Ivy keep her in line most of the time? That's what I wonder. Alright. I'll tell you one thing. Fred is gonna owe me a lot of money when he gets out of there. I've been trying to do everything in my power to try to get him out. My name has a lot of pull, but it's been pretty damn difficult. You know, money, negotiations, taunts. I've been in contact with him too, make sure that he's, you know, making sure he's alright. Trying everything I can to try to get him back in the VWF. Okay, here we go. With a face-off. Anya being a little bit cautious. We know the unpredictability factor of Harley Quinn. Already got her pinned down. Forearm shot. Two hard forearm shots. The Gears willing to do anything, to try to get themselves out of the bottom of the barrel. The juice, yeah, trying to become the juice, they're trying to transform from the juice of the garbage can to being just plain garbage in the garbage can. That can only be got rid of when you throw it outside or when you throw it down the chute. The Harley Quinn there for a ride, leapfrog. And Ani countering with a very big DDT. Side headlock punch, forearm shot, another clubbing blow, double axe handle, and another double axe handle. These heavy blows, trying to use all power moves here. Here we go, Irish whip samurai, big clothesline. The leg, one, no. Way too early to be trying to go for a pin. You're gonna need to do a lot more than that. Now on attacking salmon. Hold on, what the? Look, they learned something new. elbow drop backbreaker combo. One? Only a one count. Yeah, it's way too early, even with that. Overhead release, belly to belly suplex. Now we go, front face lock. No. Harley Quinn with the knee to the midsection. The jump kick right to the face. Side headlock. Front face lock. Vertical suplex. And the sirens, once again, just took control of back control of this match. That didn't take too long. Tornado DDT. Harley Quinn just chilling out. Supporting her, giving her tag team partners some support. Looking good, too. Seducing everybody in the crowd with her presence. Has no effect on me, though. I'm my own equivalent. Pulling her right back. Here we go. Tagging right in the Harley, the Poison Ivy, and Delio double suplex. Now, Poison Ivy's in. And so far, the Sirens have had absolute control of this matchup. The Gears have only had control only for a little while, but nope, not anymore. Leg hook, one, two, no. Poison Ivy almost got a three count off a really basic move. There we go, nice hip toss. Way beautifully executed. And here we go. Moonsault. Sam in so much trouble, it's not even funny. Cross arm neck breaker. Now tagging back in Harley Quinn, keeping Sam isolated to their side of the ring. This is basic tag team wrestling here. Tag team wrestling 101. Putting her right in the second rope. And now just choking her out with her knee. Yeah, things are not looking great for Sam. Ivy, she's like, yeah. Now they get a tag back to Harley Quinn. Got her in the arm wrench, arm drag. I would have laughed if Ivy would have covered it was a three. It's again with that bridge slam. Didn't hook the waist for the cover, though. It's as basic as moves as you can get. Two, no. Tag to Harley Quinn, and I think it's going to be time for the rocket launcher. Back suplex. Things are really going in the Gotham City Sirens' way right now. The Sirens have been in absolute control. They're dominating this matchup. This is as dominating as you can see. Sam. Trying to put a futile effort. Trying to do a futile last stand, but to no avail. DDT! And so far, once again, the Sirens are just keeping them in the corner. The Gears have barely done anything. Trying to mount some kind of offensive here. There's a counter. Sam attacking the wrong person. You know, Ivy is not the legal vixen in this matchup. And that created an opening. Ivy, thanks to, well, blah, I'm tongue-tied now. The Sirens just retook control of the matchup. That was completely quick. Frequent taps. And Ivy could be signaling for end game right about now. No, wait a minute. Sam, shoving Ivy. Close on. DBT, but I'm slowly getting back up to her feet. She's getting back up to her feet after each move here. Another overhead release belly to belly. Well, Sam might be making that tag right now. A tag would be pretty good right now. Oh, wait a minute. Victory roll. Ivy with a victory roll. One, two, no. That was very close to a three. Sam countering the elbow with a knee. Throwing Ivy right into the apron. And Ivy's like, get the hell out of here with that crap. Ivy getting back in the ring. And Anya snuck in a little shot there. Hey, Sam, connected with strikes. Anya better get back into her corner for the count of five. And I believe if this goes well, they could be getting that tag, and here we go. Are we getting tag team basics? Drop toe hold, elbow. The crowd, for some reason, wants the Gears to actually promote themselves from garbage juice to something else in the garbage. Hammer of Dawn, wheelbarrow facebuster. Lateral press, and the referee is distracted by Sam, and that was near disqualification. The Gears, Samo's got her team disqualified. And once again, the sirens just retook all that control. Elbow to the shoulders. Sitting Urza Farai right into an armbar, pulling her right into the armbar. Elbow to the back. Harley Quinn is pleased. Trying to go for something, no. Anya with a counter, into a bulldog. Now picking Harley Quinn up. Strength and power backbreaker. Could the Gears actually bounce back? Could it be possible? Yeah, Mickie attacked now to Sam. Oh. Elbow backbreaker combo! Leg hook, one, two! No! That was definitely close to three. I think that will be as close to a victory as they'll ever get. Now, Harley throwing Hassan to their corner. Here we go. And Ivy is gonna end this. They're done playing around with the Gears. Missed. Let's call that the neck breaker seduction. I'll probably give that a call if anyone has a better idea for that. Then let me know. For now, I'll call that the seduction neck breaker. Or neck breaker seduction. Anyway, here are the highlights. It was a pretty good match, but once again, the Gears are still the juice of the garbage that we one day throw in the garbage can. And speaking of that. I'm tongue-tied again. Blah. Damn it. Lightning and Urza, I guess they broke away from FCW security, are now taking their battle somewhere else in the building. Lightning, who's sick and tired of all this bullshit, all this embarrassment, this humiliation ever since Urza made her tap out for the very first time in her career. Lightning has finally lost it. The greatest of all time is angry and frustrated. And right now, I guess the only thing on her mind right now is kicking Urza's ass. And they've been fighting, I'm going to probably assume, everywhere in the building, practically. Hell, I guarantee they probably beat up the FCW security. I mean, who's going to be dumb enough to try to stop these two? And oh, wait a minute, she's going to try to make her tap out in the back? Come on, lady, no, 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 yes, 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 thank you. The greatest of all time will not stand for this. And at Finn Vital, Lightning will destroy Urza. She will put her through that damn table. Lightning is throwing Urza around on that concrete floor. Showing number throwing her right into that window. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, oh my god, yes! Lightning got her revenge on Urza and put her through that damn window. Glass everywhere. Lightning has won this round. We can light him, but can the greatest put Urza through a table and get her payback? What a message sent by Lightning to Urza. She ain't standing for that bullshit anymore. But anyway, guys, it is main event time. Main event. Rinoa, can she finally get her justice? Can she finally get her revenge on Yuna? You know, the old Team Final Fantasy, they only lasted, I don't know, 2 weeks. And Yuna came out and she's like, I'm taking a read through that. Which led to all this. It looks like the curse on Rinoa regarding the tag team division has been lifted for the time being. But it ain't about tag teams, this is about payback. Yo, Final Fantasy VIII versus Final Fantasy X. Never know what's right. Is Yuna ready? Oh no! Oh no! What do you want? What the hell does the boss want? It scares me every. It pisses me off every time I have to say that. Okay. Ban. Haruka and Michiru are banned from ringside. Well, essentially, you're pretty much banned. Fair my ass. You saying this could be a fair match is like saying somebody can beat Dark Souls on the first playthrough. Oh yeah, fair, really? You call that fair? If people are banned from the Nova side, Yuna's gonna have Ryu. Oh, so that's fair game. I'm telling you guys, the way that Nio's been doing all, making all these weird, crazy decisions, all these weird ideas, all these weird little things, and cutthroat, he should make me feel like a saint. Everybody knows how much I hate it, almost a lot of people would say that. I got a lot of enemies. She makes me feel like a freaking angel. Freaking fair my ass. I guarantee you Riga's gonna have something up her sleeve. I mean, hell, she's probably still butthurt at the fact that bringing Tina beat her earlier thanks to Bashir. If I was her, no, I'm gonna have that with eyes in the back of my head. One eye, both eyes in the front for Yuna, eyes in the back for Riku. This was not gonna be simple. And Riku already getting on the apron, even though the referee can't really do much because she's not doing anything illegal yet. Rinoa with the Samoa drop. Rinoa not gonna let that phase her. Gotta wonder. With the way Mia's been behaving, with the way Mia's been acting. I mean, there's no love lost. It's well documented the hatred that she's had for the Senshi. And it's spread it to the Daughters of Darkness. Look at this Yuna conversing with Riku. Trying to think of a battle strategy, some kind of battle strategy. And Rinoa's like, man, screw your battle strategy. And Yuna responding in kind with a great equalizer, thumb in the eye. And with Riku here, this could be a deciding factor for this could be one of the main factors for this matchup. Now Yuna sending Rinoa into the corner. Referee getting the hell out of Dodge. Monkey flip. Yuna, former NGW's women's champion back in the day. Former VWF Intergalactic Champion. Man, big glumming blow. Rinoa trying to bag body drop Yuna to the outside. No, Yuna countering. Yuna with an elbow. Springboard Hurricane Rana. Leg hook, one, only one. Neck rip. Rinoa trying to punch Yuna. Yuna countering with a punch of her own. The odds are have really stacked against Rinoa right now. Rinoa with a jawbreaker, and the crowd is already on their feet. Rinoa got Yuna pinned to the corner. Laying it down. Laying down the hammer. Hammer time. Hammer time. Yuna with a spinning head scissors. We just immediately turned that around. His elbow. Now side head Naku. Face first into the canvas. Cover. One. Two. No. Figure four neck lock, elbow right to the top of the head. Your skull will be hurting. DDT. Rinoa, bring it to Yuna. And once again, going right back to that figure four neck lock and elbow. And she's got Yuna over the shoulder. But wait a minute, no. Yuna countering right into a DDT. Oh, wait a minute. Yuna got her up. Could be powerbomb time. And there it is. A big powerbomb and was cover. One, two, no. Only a two count. Wait, what the? Only one. That was the fastest roll up I ever seen. Look at this. Look at Riku. Look at Riku arguing with the official. And now we're doing. Going right back on the top rope. She's going to try to drop the big leg. Oh my. Oh no. No, that was a serious miss, and that could be. Things are going to go south. Yuna could be shutting up for Shatter Spear. No. Backdrop bottom. Now going up top. Gonna try to go for the leg. This time the leg in X. And it could be time for the Fallen Angel. And there it is. Double underhook. The Fallen Angel. She connected with the Fallen Angel. It could be over right now. It could be over. What? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, fair, right? You call this fair. And Rinoa still staying on Yuna. She's telling Yuna, look at this, Riku. It's so frustrated at the fact that at the fact she tore my table apart. One, two, no. My anime is everywhere. Now I gotta go pick it all up. All right, all my anime's picked up. We're gonna sneak eyes in Yuna. I can see the frustration in Riku's face right now. Now, once again, elbowing Yuna right in the skull. She's like, hey man, if you keep distracting the referee, I'm just going to kick her ass even more. And that's exactly what Rinoa's doing right now. Rinoa's a big house of fire right now. Elbow drop to the back of the head. Another elbow dropped in the back of the head. Big clothesline. Let's throw her into the corner again. And then, oh, Yuna with the quick evasion into her own DDT. Over. Wait a minute. You gotta roll up. She got schoolboy. One. Or the schoolgirl would be more appropriate. No. The schoolgirl was not enough. Taking her right back down with the clothesline. Gonna try the schoolgirl again. One. Two. No. And look at this. Real counter. One. Two. Oh, you gotta be kidding. Look at this. Yuna countering Rinoa with the backslide. But look at this, Riku is distracting the referee, possibly costing Yuna her chance of getting a win. And wait a minute. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Yuna frustrated, she took out the referee. And judging by it, looks like Riku has been banned from the island. Booted from the island? No, she's not. Another fallen angel. Yes, Riku has been booted off the island. 1, 2, 3. Poetic justice has just been served. Even with the odds stacked, Rinoa was still able to take out Yuna and ultimately get her revenge for all this crap that she put her through since the War Games and before. I can really truly say, guys, I'm thrilled that this victory strengthens the soul of Rinoa. There's a final fallen angel that was nailed in the coffin, Riku getting booted from the island. Yeah, take that, Neo. Rinoa celebrating, she has every right to celebrate. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're running out of time. This is the JM Factor. I'll see you guys next week for more VWF.
Hey, everybody, this is Friday J. Francis letting you know that we have the official VWF wiki page. Where you can find in our wiki? Well, you can find history of all of our events and championships, in-depth Nitro episodes, and the entire roster and staff for you to check out. We are constantly updating, so check us out at vixenswf.wikia.com.